Welcome to Cultural Heritage at Risk in Defense of Civilization. My name is Karen Kiorbas. I am the preservation librarian here at the University at Albany. I've spent a good part of my career training library, archives, and museum professionals in emergency planning and assisting with response and recovery when problems do occur. And trust me, the best way to learn about response is at someone else's disaster. A couple of years ago, I had the privilege of serving on the steering committee for the new College of Emergency Preparedness, Homeland Security, and Cybersecurity. And I decided I wanted to know more about the research being done in the area of protecting cultural heritage. So I organized today's event, hoping not just to inform the community and University of Albany students of some of the issues, but also to promote investigation into this area of specialization. Dr. Brian Daniels will open today's program talking about exactly that. He will discuss some of the data needs that exist in order to develop a more robust understanding about data of cultural destruction. From there, we have three more speakers this morning who will speak to climate change and the impact of natural disasters on cultural heritage. This afternoon, after lunch, we will direct our attention to focus on war, violence, and terrorism and the risks they present to culture and communities. Throughout the day today, I invite you to be thinking, what are the research gaps? Where is data needed to improve planning, mitigation, response, and recovery? I mean, the storms are getting bigger, and so can we. Allow me first to thank our sponsors, the University at Albany for a conference support award, the University Libraries, CEHC, the Honors College, Anthropology, and Art History for student scholarships to attend today's event, and the New York State Education Department. Please note that today's program is being recorded. If you have a question, please raise your hand and a runner will bring you a microphone. We'll have one on each side of the room. This way your questions are captured in the audio file. All our volunteers have the word volunteer on their badge. Will you please stand up if you're here? Who are my volunteers? You want to just stand up and make yourself known? There's a few others out in the hallway. Okay, so if you have questions, look for one of us and we'll be able to point you in the right direction. I want to point out the restrooms, just a little bit of housekeeping, out the door here and to your left. And because this is a conference on emergency management, I'd be remiss if I didn't point out the emergency exits. There's one at the front, one at the back, and in the middle. I guess I'm supposed to do this. Somebody said that I have to do this. So, let me now introduce Dean Rebecca Mugridge, University Libraries, to welcome you to Cultural Heritage at Risk. Thank you.
Welcome to the University at Albany and to the Cultural Heritage at Risk Conference. I'm very pleased that the University Libraries could co-sponsor this day-long conference that brings together researchers from many disciplines to talk about how we can protect and preserve our cultural heritage from the effects of climate change, war, and terrorism. This conference exemplifies how the University at Albany faculty and staff are engaged with and committed to our communities. Our collective history and culture are critical to supporting democracy and understanding who we are and how we fit into this world. This conference presents research that informs how we can protect and preserve that cultural heritage. I'm pleased that it is brought to you through a collaborative effort by the University Libraries, the College of Emergency Preparedness, Homeland Security, and Cybersecurity, and the New York State Department of Education, and I hope it leads to many future collaborations. Finally, I want to acknowledge and thank Karen Kiorkas, head of the Alice Hastings Murphy Preservation Department, whose vision led to this conference. I hope you all have a great day. Now I'd like to introduce the new president of the University at Albany, President Javidan Rodriguez.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody, and thank you so very much for being here. Certainly a pleasure to join you this morning, to welcome you, and to say thank you for being here to discuss this incredibly important topic, preserving our cultural heritage, particularly as we look at this through an interdisciplinary view, right? Focusing on it, whether you include all the folks that are here from the library to the College of Emergency Preparedness, Homeland Security, and Cybersecurity, Atmospheric Sciences, and a variety of other disciplines to really have a holistic understanding and a holistic approach about how we approach this very important topic. You know, the preservation of our cultural heritage, particularly when we focus on wars and civil unrest, as we focus on natural catastrophes, whether it be Hurricane Harvey, Hurricane Irma, Hurricane Maria, Hurricane Katrina, as we focus on sort of the significant disasters and critical issues that we have across our globe, preserving our cultural heritage is incredibly important. I remember when I was at the University of Delaware talking to an art historian about the preservation of our cultural heritage, particularly at that time in the context of Iraq, and really bringing in art historians and bringing in librarians and bringing in social scientists and others to focus on how is it exactly that we do this, because this is critical to what we do. This is a great conversation today, a great discussion that's really going to help us in terms of our understanding of this critical issue, and more importantly, how do we move forward? So I want to thank each and every one of you for being here. I want to thank you for your ongoing engagement in this important topic, and I wish you all the best today as you have these hopefully engaging and exciting and informative conversations that will result in a plan of action to move us forward in terms of thinking about our cultural heritage and how do we preserve it at a time of risk, disasters, and catastrophes. Thank you so very much.
Chief Academic Officer, for those of you that don't know. You know that term has an origin in the military. It means keeper of the prisons. We don't have any prisons here. But what we do have is an enormous collection of diverse faculty who are doing all kinds of work that I love when it comes together across disciplines. Because from the perch of the provost's office, it's really all one university. So I'm just love reading through this program and seeing how the different perspectives combine. And this is not a surprise, knowing our Dean of the Libraries and you, for organizing this, because the libraries are everywhere. They organize knowledge for the whole world, but certainly across the breadth of disciplines. And they also provide an emotional home for the campus. The libraries remain the heart of the campus, even though we thought some years ago they would just all turn into stuff that you could get off your cell phone. But that's not true. It's where our students go, it's where our faculty go. So these two critical functions combine, and they really are interdisciplinary. And then you throw on top of that our brand new College of Emergency Preparedness, Homeland Security, and Cybersecurity, which we think is the longest named college in America. But it's new, and it is fundamentally interdisciplinary. And then you all come to make this program happen. So this is a great vision. It's important that we do this. I just want to say thank you for being here and contributing to the interdisciplinary function as well as the excellence function of the University at Albany. Thank you.
I have to keep moving this down a little and up a little. Okay. Next, may I present Dean Robert Griffin from the College of Emergency Preparedness, Homeland Security, and Cybersecurity.
Can you all hear me? Morning, everybody. I'm Bob Griffin. I'm the Dean of the College of Emergency Preparedness, Homeland Security Cybersecurity. Deal I cut with the provost and president is I'm paid according to the letters in the name of the college. So we will continue to add titles to the college name. Karen, thank you very much for organizing. You know, you're going to hear a lot today about cultural heritage, but what I want you to start to think about is what you're talking about is community soul. We're talking about the souls of our community. And if you think about the 9/11 attack, it was as much an attack on our iconic structures, our cultural heritage. It was purposely aimed at images of our trade strength and our military strength. So you start to think about the importance that our cultural heritage institutions play in our community. It takes on a whole different role we start to think about its relationship with Homeland Security and emergency preparedness. And frankly, for really evil people, and you'll hear about really evil people later from Victor and others, if you want to destroy a people, destroy their cultural heritage. So as you go through the day, I hope you can do a couple of things. I hope you can really start to think about the risk and threat that our cultural heritage institutions face, how we can sort of buy down that risk and threat. But equally important, though, this isn't just a session on safety and security. It needs to be balanced with how do we preserve access? How do we increase and improve what the base mission of our cultural heritage facilities are to a community? How do we think differently about what their role is during a disaster and how we make sure that they continue to represent the soul of the community. I hope you have a wonderful day. This is a really important series of sessions that you're going to participate in. And the work we do to help protect our cultural heritage helps protect our national identity. Karen, again, thank you very much for all the work you did putting this together. Rebecca, thank you for the relationship with the libraries. We really appreciate it. Have a wonderful day.